So let's release infraspinatus and teres minor. These are the muscles that externally rotate the shoulder. So we have three big giant muscles that internally rotate, and we have just two kind of little muscles that externally rotate. And infraspinatus and teres minor are really beneficial to release these muscles for all sorts of shoulder pain, arm pain, numbness. These muscles live right on the shoulder blade itself. So we have to roll, I like to use a pink ball or even a handball, something smaller, to work right on the shoulder blade itself. So let's make sure we can find where that is. You're gonna reach your opposite hand fingers across the top of the shoulder, and you'll find that there's a bone across the top of the shoulder. That's called the spine of the scapula, or the spine of the shoulder blade. And that's a really good marker. So infraspinatus tends to hold its points right underneath that spine of the shoulder blade and in the center of the shoulder blade itself. And then teres minor is right up here in that inner or the outer corner of the shoulder blade. So we're gonna get into that as well. So we're gonna work the other side. So you can see, I'm gonna take the ball in my opposite hand and just reach around to get on the shoulder blade itself. And then I can use my fingers to feel, here's that spine of the scapula, and I wanna get right underneath that area. So it's really helpful to use your other hand as a marker. And then I'm gonna roll right underneath that spine of the scapula. And I can follow it all the way out to the edge. And right there, usually in the corner, can be a tender spot. And it might be nice to just kind of roll around the whole of the shoulder blade. I wanna move this ball down just a little bit so I can be a little more in my knees. And roll all on top of the shoulder blade. I'm right on that bone. So I don't need a lot of pressure because the tissue is thin here. And then as I come out, I find that out that inner corner of the scapula, the shoulder blade, and I find a tender spot right there, and I'm just gonna sink into it. And take a breath. And then I'm gonna move outward toward the outer shoulder. And I find right underneath there, right under that spine of the scapula, I find some tenderness right there as well. I'm gonna hold and breathe. The arm is relaxed. I'm just gonna roll all around the shoulder blade. I might move my ball down a little bit. I'm just kind of rolling on the shoulder blade, exploring and finding. And I'm finding a spot right there. So that's a nice tender spot. I'm gonna sink my body weight into the wall, into the ball, and hold and breathe. And for our pin and stretch for this muscle, because it externally rotates the shoulder, if I just rotate my arm, an internal and external rotation, or just turn the shoulder in and turn the shoulder out, I can feel the ball moving over some tenderness. So I can play with that a little bit. And now I want to move up into teres minor at the very upper corner of the shoulder blade. This spot is really tender on most people. So I'm gonna get that ball right in the corner, in that upper corner of the shoulder blade, and I rock forward and back to kind of trap the point. I might go up and down right in that upper corner. So we're gonna find a tender spot and take a breath. And sometimes I like to work where I even bend a little forward and hang the arm a little bit. And then I can really just move my knees up and down, bend my knees and straighten my legs a bit, and massage right along that corner edge. And right here is my most tender spot. So I'm going to hold it, take a deep breath. And then release. So using the ball underneath that spine of the scapula and in that corner will help to release the external rotators of the shoulder, which often get out of balance with the pull of the three big muscles that internally rotate the shoulders. So you'll want to do the other side, taking the ball underneath, finding the spine of the scapula, taking the ball right underneath there, rolling all around the shoulder blade itself, pausing and sinking in tender spots, and then working the outer corner way up high to get the teres minor.